When I talk about respectable sins, next slide. What is respectable sins, okay? Respectable sins are those sins which are in our lives, okay? আমি কেন দেখে নিলে ইগনোর করে লাগা সিনস কেন আমি কিন্তু সিনফুল পার্সন আছে আমি কিন্তু খালি সেক্সুয়াল ইমোরালিটি না বিয়া কাম করে লাগা বডি আর মুটু খান কি মনো সিনিয়র হই দো রাইট মুটু খান চেস্ট তে তা খান লেতে বিয়া মানু ইফ দ্যাট পার্সন ইজ স্লিপিং উইথ সামবডি এলস লেত্রা মানু রাইট ইফ দ্যাট পার্সন ইজ অলওয়েজ কোয়ারেলিং ড্রিঙ্কিং ওকে মুটু খান ঝগড়া করে দিলে কি বিয়া মানু বাট হোয়াট অ্যাবাউট দোজ সিনস হুইচ আর ইন আওয়ার লাইফ এভরিডে There are sins in our life that we knowingly ignore, saying that we are human. The excuse, okay, the word "ami do manu ase," it's an excuse for those who don't want to grow. Okay, you know, ami no puncha manu sa ami manu ase do. After all, and we don't improve, right? It's an excuse for those who don't want to grow in the Lord. And then, are you with me, church? So respectable sins, okay? Now, can we turn to the next slide? There's a virus known as time bomb virus. Do you know this virus? Have you ever heard of time bomb virus? All right. While I was in Nilit, okay, I read about this time bomb virus. So what is time bomb virus? Time bomb virus, okay, as you know, a virus more like computer to push you, okay? So if you computer to push you, which is it, that virus detect my pen drive TV. Skin grow, detect no more. But after some time, okay, maybe even after 3-4 years, it will crash your entire computer, so file and delete your job. That's called time bomb virus. Computer pura bihag with it. Okay? So there are sins in our life which we keep on ignoring. Ignore great. Have you ever appreciated last time we can have a spiritual life? Okay? Those sins are called respectable sins, which you think that I'm with the time is not knowing which of which we keep those sins in our life, man respect bra. Taikam to bhal sin nishna. Okay, we consider those sins as small sin. Which of me gi, I mean a life tido thakya da, I mean manu ase. Those are called respectable sins. I mean kan kitabi ni kidai, I mean a life tira kidai. Just like a virus, not virus, cancer. Cancer is not making a bili tanya manu an. Aste aste tanya right? Hui jawo na lagi wo, hui jawo na nago bimar nuwa. Aste aste wo after 20-30 years pichde cancer ay jaro right? And it destroys our body immediately. Na kami kui tigyo tobacco an kai tigyo kai tigyo na achana achana pra pichde after not now but after 20-30 years suddenly oral cancer ay jaro right? So this, if you, there are sins in our life, okay? That is like a cancer. It won't show the results now, but later it will destroy our soul, our spirit, okay? It will destroy us as a Christian. So those are called respectable sins, okay? So I'm going to bring around 6 or 7 respectable sins over the next 2-3 services. Every service we'll be covering just two of it, okay? So even today we'll be covering two respectable sins. And the first one is ungodliness. Have you heard of the word called ungodliness? Yeah? So ungodliness, okay? Romans 1:18 says that for the wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness, right? So this person who live a respectable life, but God is irrelevant in his or her life, is called ungodliness, okay? Ungodliness, people. This can, you know, we can fall into that category, okay? I mean, Christian church service come grow, isola ka come grow, okay? But yet, I mean, isola the relationship na ka grow. See, we can see that due to categorized within us, right? Ungodliness is different, unrighteousness is different. Yeah? Unrighteousness are those, you know, it's okay, life in the letter, man. It will be another category. Ungodliness. They are those respectable people, okay? Society, bia, zibin hoi. Tan mudu nakao, tan kiki nakai. Bia kaam nukure. Really, we can't, taikan our lives, they, it's okay, acknowledge nukure, kitabi. They don't acknowledge God in their life. They don't have relationship with God. That's called ungodliness. We can be working in the church but yet not have relationship with God. Amen? I can be preaching in the church but yet not have relationship with God. Come on. I can be worshiping in the worship team but yet I cannot have relationship with God. Right? You and I might be working in the church for 30 years but without relationship with God. That's called ungodliness. There's no God in his or her life. There's no place for God in their life. That's called ungodliness. Are you with me? Can you turn to James 4:13? Next, yeah. Next slide. Now listen, you who says today or tomorrow we will go to this or that city, spend a year there, carry on business and make money. Why do you not even know what will happen tomorrow? What is your life? You are a mist that appears for a little while and then vanishes. Instead, you ought to say, if it is the Lord's will, we will live and do this or that. See, when, you know, this word of God, James, okay, is not against people doing business, okay? We should know this. Business created against widow. The word of God is not against doing business, right? But the word of God is against not acknowledging God in your business. Amen? James is not against we making a business. James is not against we making a plan, but he was against making a plan without Jesus in our lives. Amen. We can make program without God interference, right? We can make some very beautiful program without God in it. Ungodly program, right? Because we see so many ungodly activities in the church too, where God is not honored by those things. Where God is not honored by those songs. We can make so many programs in the church, but yet God won't be honored. You know, God is not honored in that service. So James was not against people carrying out a business. James was not against carrying out a plan. But James was against those who were making plans without God in their lives. Without acknowledging God in that business. So maybe today we might be doing business, maybe today we might be doing church work, maybe today we might be studying and trying to give exams, but without acknowledging Jesus in our lives. And there's the difference, right? We might be working in the church, but without Jesus in our lives. We might be a good Christian with a moral upright, right? Manula akiri bishi ba society di manu respect kore, but we might not have a relationship with God. So that's called ungodliness. Are you with me? Can we turn to the next verse, Prashant? Colossians 1:10 says that, for this reason, since the day we have heard about you, we have not stopped praying for you. We continually ask God to fill you with the knowledge of His will through all the wisdom and understanding that the Spirit gives, so that you may live a life worthy of the Lord and please Him in every way, bearing fruit in every good work, growing in the knowledge of God. So that you may live a life worthy of the Lord. Amen? And please Him in every way, bearing fruit. In everything that we do, let our life be a pleasing to the Lord. Amen? I mean, relationship to be isor laga. If you are in a relationship, God should be the center of everything that you do. I heard Alawan wrote this, you know, many years ago I heard a song from Alawan. And it was a song, a love story that is centered around Jesus. And he wrote on the lyrics, which I really love, and oh what a beautiful day it is. And oh what a beautiful day it is. He wrote that, I mean, Dijun Bahar Jaze, Mikey Mujun. I pray for the Lord to bless our day together. I pray to the Lord to bless our day together. Right? So, you know, he was saying that, I mean, Bahar Jaze, I'm hanging out with that girl, but I pray that the Lord will be the center of everything. So, Bible tells us that whatever we do, you know, let our life be pleasing to the Lord. Amen? So whatever business that we do, Jesus should be the center of that. And Jesus is honored through that. Amen. Every activities that we do, Jesus should be honored. Amen. Can we turn to next verse, Prashant? Yeah. One more time. Colossians 3:22-24, it says, you know, slaves, obey your earthly masters in everything, and do it not only when their eyes is on you and to curry their favor, but with sincerity of heart and reverence for the Lord. Whatever you do, work at it with all your heart as working for the Lord, not for human masters. Since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward, it is Lord Christ you are serving, right? So Paul is telling the people of Colossians, okay, that slave can give was it. Only come grace, nilibi kali manua dikhara deka kam grubi, right? Don't do your work to please the people, to that person, but do your work to please God. In other sense, that whatever work you are doing, let it be honorable to God. Amen? So if you are doing work at home, let it be honorable to God, not your mother. Kali amagi dikhau lekna kam grubo. Baba had the baba ibu ikhara chukapa kam grubo, no. Do it so that you honor God with your work. Amen? Not to all, you know, Baba ki bui karne, not out of fear, but out of reverence for the Lord. So that the work that you do will be pleasing before the Lord. Amen? So in other sense, that akili business tangisha, right? Only bahari ki kam reza, let it be pleasing to the Lord. Whatever you're doing at home, let it be pleasing to the Lord. Amen? Because there are people, okay, when we, you know, they worship God Saturday, Sunday, they worship God in service, but when they go home and do their activities, you know, college activities, every work, they totally forget about God. Like God is out of their thoughts. Isoro tala thought tibi nai, tala conversation tibi, isoro honor grobalela nai, relationship tibi, Isor ki honor grobole la nai, siblings bitona relationship pi isor ki honor no grobole ta dewa. Do you know that we can honor God even through the relationship that we have with siblings? Come on. Yeah? Human nature is a chakra guri tekule, no. I told you, right? Human manua se, it's an excuse for you not to grow in that relationship. Amen? Manua se chakra guri wo. Dada bhaiya bitore, it's an excuse for you not to build that relationship or to become better in that relationship. Amen. So what are we to do? We should honor God even at home, in our work, in everything that we do. Amen. Let it be pleasing to God. Next verse, 1 Corinthians, we will run, okay? 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31. Next prediction. So whatever you eat or drink or whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God. That's called godliness. Okay? Ungodliness is where Jesus is not invited in any areas of your life. Even to us Christians, okay? You might know Jesus, but you might not have Jesus with you, right? I mean, Jesus is not the center of everything that you do. So whatever you eat or drink, and whatever is whatever, right? Whatever you do, do it all for the glory of God, even while you are going shopping. Okay? Dukan walang yun sukan ng nai. Even while you are going for shopping, girls or even boys, don't threaten the place wala. Nakamnu, right? Even nakamaykin yun kaya jay do. Place walang gisab na, right? Bayad mo ate, nilu mali mo nila na. So we don't honor people, you know, doing the business, right? So we are to honor God even while we are going shopping. We are to honor God while we are even bargaining. Because I remember an uncle saying to, you know, his wife, I mean, you should help Jaleda on his second in the Jujia Rane Jawa Panjina. They went, Tuesday Basara Jaisi, Kilo Detajun. Tuesday Basara Jaiana, over negotiate Pujia. 2000 laga itu reduction aja ke, right? Dividend lah. 2000 laga, kiman sama tadi sih, tapi 5,600 per kini naik sih. And he said that, I mean, did you not have enough of all the negotiate for him? Over bargaining, which is a mother loss kaya dengan di sana, right? So, itu mother whole day ku bikin bro panen, tapi jadi kini, so they want to sell something, right? But at the expenses of that person suffering. So you see, we should honor God, you know? Even our negotiation with people should be honorable to God. Are you with me? You know, Jesus becomes center of everything, right? That we should bless people. Even through, you know, while we're shopping. I remember, you know, I just want to post for Illinois. Really be, just last month it was a very hard time, right? I think it was June or July. I go to office regularly, right? So, kapur sila ulit jesi. Aro kami laga kapur sila do, it was 150. So malik problem si 150 esen nili ane kushi tibi. You know, so tada babija ane kanti tibo. So I just gave him 150 and I said, it's very hard time. Pandemic ase bishi dikta time ase. So why don't you just take 100 extra? With 150 I gave 100 extra to him. You see, we honor God even while we are shopping, okay? It's not every day about bargaining. It's good to bless somebody sometimes, okay? It's not that, ah, you should have quite a bit of a no. When you give extra to somebody, if he or she is attending the shop, right? He gets, he or she gets 3,000 a month. When you bless the person with extra 50 or extra 100, ito dineta kibakta kimina jawo, right? Kibakta kaole laga. Have you ever thought that way, you know, while you're going for shopping? We never do, right? Bless them, like, bless them even while you're shopping. That's why, you know, we do that. Why? Because we honor God, not because we are rich or to show that we are, you know, we should reach numbers of more. Amen? We do that because we honor God even through that. Amen? So even while you are in, you know, social relationship and everything, so all that we do should be pleasing to God. Amen? And everything that we do, we should honor God. And even, that includes even while driving. Drive you get two chances there, right? That buri wants to cross the road, but we just keep on going the cars. So when we stop our car to let people go, they want to cross, they're carrying things, you know? But the Naga people have this very bad habit because we don't have red light and everything, right? So we just keep on going, we don't let people cross. But what we do even while we're driving, you know, we stop our vehicle to let people go, you know? And they, you know, they're thankful to what we've done, right? It's okay, thanks, they think that way when we live another, right? So that's cool, you know, honoring God and pleasing God in every day of our lives. Amen? I mean, on a business, as we end this ungodliness topic, a child said, okay, to pastor. Pastor was preaching about God in the image, you know, that man was made in the image of God. So then he said, you know, he gave an altar call of getting born again. So what the child replied to pastor at the end of the service, pastor, I wanted to accept Jesus in my life. But if my Jesus is like my, if the God that you call is like my father, I'm never giving my life to Jesus. Are you getting me? If the God that you are talking about, since you say that we are made in God's image, if my father is made in God's image, then I don't want that Jesus in my life. Why? Because his father was not a good man. His father was not honoring God even at home. His father was abusive. His father, that's why the child never wanted to accept Jesus. Amen. Manura Jesus accept problem munjata giwi, amina na behavior amina stop prito. Amina na family ki sora fale grow munjata giwi, amina father change grow munjata giwi, because of our behavior that person won't give his or her life to Jesus, because that person will say he goes to church every Sunday but he don't change, then why should I go to church, right? That's why respectable sins should not be ignored. The sins that we take so casually in our life, saying, ikune manu ase, amen? We should take it seriously. Are you guys with me? So the next and the last point is this. Can you turn to the next verse? Okay, let's... okay, because like I said now, okay, that no wonder the scripture says that Gentile blaspheme the name of God because of you. Jews can be kwaze, okay? Those Jews, okay? Jews can do one law so jane nishna, right? Those Pharisees, they can do Bible so jane nishna, Jews can do Bible so jane nishna. They can do life to Bible is something na thakye vishye. So the Gentiles, those who don't know the Lord, started blaspheming the name of God, okay? Blaspheming the name of God because of you. So people would blaspheme Christianity because of our lives. Amen? Those unbelievers would look at us, our behavior, and say that if Christianity is like that, I don't need your God. If the Christianity that you profess is like this, the life that you show, then I don't want that Christianity. Are you with me? I remember reading in Facebook a few days ago, I don't know how many of you have seen the column, but I think a Nagao person wrote one particular incident that happened a few days ago. Three or four people were drunk. At the middle of the night, they were knocking some Subar place, Manulang Gordon. They were knocking, and since they refused to open, they knocked down the door. Like, without no reason, they started beating. That's the Christianity that we show to the people. To the unbelievers. Gentiles are those who don't believe in Jesus, right? I mean, thank you, Gentiles, come to thank you, it's okay, not Gentiles, right? Pagans can be worshipped. So, it's okay, Janule Munjai, People want to know Jesus, but through our behavior, people don't like to accept Jesus. They don't want to come to Christianity because we don't show the Christianity to them through our lives. Amen? Amen. So the last point is discontentment, okay? So the word discontentment is very, very relevant to all of us. Discontentment, we all know, right, that kita bhi mon bhota dhuwa laga. We want more and more and more, right? Discontentment is wanting more and more all the time. Contentment, right? Discontentment is everything about wanting more and more and more. So the second point about respectable sins, the sins that we so happily ignore, is discontentment in our life. And discontentment started from heaven itself. From Lucifer, right? He was not happy and contented with the position that he had. So he rebelled against God because he wanted to be more powerful. He wanted more, right? Yeah, come on. He wanted more position, more, you know, higher position than God. He wanted to be in the level of God. Discontentment, mon bata nuwa laga, sukru bata nuwa laga, right? That's what we call in Nagamis. And comes next in the book of Genesis. Satan used the same tactics to Eve. Come on. That God, you know, whatever God says is, you know, not true, right? You can be like Him if you eat that fruit, right? This contentment mon bata nuwa laga Eve ke kuiti shiro. Come on. And Eve said, alright, I'll be more powerful. She jani jawab, right? After that, she committed sin. And that same discontentment continues even today. Discontentment, I mean, in the life, just contentment. Buka manu, kalado, will be. Buka manu, those white people, skin tan, brunette, aro sun, the general brunette, right? Kala manu, aro kala buka woman jai. Patlam, again, all of most of woman jai, right? Most of again, all of patla woman jai. Kata again, lambauja, woman jai, lambabshi, lambau, manukuma again, mumbishi lambauja, makian. Over lambo jenetan bui kai mota na pao gana. Aro bishi kata dali ana kaya mota na pao negi mo bishi kata uji, right? We are never happy and contented with what we have, right? We buy a bike, now next what happens is, I want to buy a car. You buy Alto 800, next I want to buy Duster. You buy Duster, next what happens? I want to buy Scorpion. Just kidding, right? Not Scorpion, but Scorpion. So, see, we want to buy more and more. First, before I had Motorola with me, okay? Motorola phone, you take action. So next, what happened was I wanted to buy Nokia. And next came Chinese phone, which was like a city bus, right? Big one. You do you remember? Come on. There was this Chinese phone that came to Nagaland with a big, big screen. And I wanted to buy that. After buying that, I wanted more again. And after buying those phones, I wanted iPhone again. After buying iPhone, I was not happy. I wanted 6GB RAM. I went for Oppo with 4GB RAM. And I was not happy with Oppo. I decided to buy again Redmi Note Pro. But now, I said, Lord, this is it. I'm not buying any phone for now, okay? Let me be contented with what I have. See, we humans, our wants are like limitless, right? We want more and more and more and more. And that is not good. Discontentment, there is positive discontentment and negative discontentment, okay? Discontentment in the sense that, you know, you are not happy with the present situation in Nagaland, but so you want Nagaland to become better. That's called good discontentment, alright? That you're not satisfied with the present situation, the present scenario of Nagaland, so you want Nagaland to become better. You're not satisfied this currently in your home, so you are discontented, so you want your family to become better. You're not satisfied, you know that only job na finance, you want to study hard and you want something in your life. Bishi lagi ase. That's called good this that content ekta bhal ekta ro, okay, that you're not content with what you have. You want more. So bhal rahi thaki dili bi this unhealthy discontentment. Okay? Where we want so much more than what we have, we go to that position where we don't even thank God for what we have. Amen? Discontentment. And because it takes you to thanks in the Nisrogye. We heard this proverb, right? That grass always looks greener on the other side. How many of you have seen the photography in Instagram? Have you seen the green, beautiful grass? But inside, it's like really dirty, right? We all know that. It was pani khiti do. Bar bar mas sudur dikhe sa photography ko mal dikhe. And it was edited moreover. Inside the field, there was dirt. So ami ko na amuang na satisfied noy do. Manu ki lagas itu side dikhe, right? Discontentment. Saying, I want that whatever the person is wearing. I want that whatever the person is using. Envy grasa, discontentment by envy grasa rejai. And that is not good. Amen? Discontentment is not healthy when you don't even recognize the financial problem in your family and you want more and more. Numbers, we remember the fish we eat for free in Egypt. And we have all the cucumbers, melons, leek, onions and garlic we wanted, but now our appetite are gone. All we ever see is this manna. Let's stick there, okay? I think this will be the last verse that we are reading. So this is Israelites and that is who we are. Israelites for God, that God rescued them from Egypt. Israelites for God, that God rescued them from the soldiers of the Pharaoh, who were about to slaughter them, kill them, right? Israelites for God, that God departed sea for them. Israelites for God, that God healed them. Amen? Israelites for God, the love and mercy that God showed over them, the protection that He had over them. And all they started worrying, all they cared about was the meat that they were eating, right? Egyptian tagyaran de ayah, utukhaite gishido, right? Discontentment, they were not happy with what they had. So I told you in the beginning, right? Discontentment would lead to bitterness towards God. They were discontented, which led to their complaining against God, right? When you are not contented with what you have, it will lead to bitterness. You're not contented with your dress, you're not contented with your family, you know? I wish I had a family, I wish that I had, you know, I was in that family. Content no ina tagyaran de, I mean, it's all like a sin with it, bitterness. Amen, are you with me, church? Alright, I think there is one quote, yeah. Content makes poor man rich, discontent makes rich man poor. Come on, this is good, right? When you are contented with everything, with anything that you have, you are rich because you are happy with it. You live a good life, you know how? Ki yase so many things, right? Chapal tuti na zai kunhuay, rishu abadi na chura. Oh, you are happy with that. But if you are discontented with everything that you have, kuma nutun juta lagay na awon next orala bal lagi mo. Juta bal yede lagay na awon itukan la classes sa dego. Not happy. When you are living a life that is discontented, you would never be happy. Amen. Discontented life, you will never be happy. So, you know, this discontentment and ungodliness is a cancer to our soul. That is going to eat everything that's inside of us. Amen. So, as we even end up, I think, Sean, this one. Yeah, I think next. Each of you should continue to live whatever situation the Lord has placed you with. Continue to live in whatever situation God has placed you with your family, okay? It's over, you know, that it is easy to accept, Karina, be thankful. And remain as you were when God first called you. This is my rule for all the churches. Amen. Be contented, be great, be happy with whatever God has blessed you with. You know, be happy with it, okay? Kata lamba ikunoi, pakta mote ikunoi. Bishi extra khaikna mosto wada, that's your fault, okay? You can become slim. Bishi patla ikunoi. What can I do, right? But be happy with how God created you. Amen? Be happy with what you have. Next. Yes, Romans 8:32. Since he did not spare even his own son, but gave up all for us, won't he also give us everything else? Amen? Since he did not hold anything from giving us, he did not even hold Jesus to die on the cross for us, whatever you need in the right time, he will provide. God will take care of our needs. Okay? Don't go too much for the wants. Are you with me? There's difference between needs and wants, okay? There's something that you need. If you don't have any shoe and you are praying for a shoe, that's a need. If you have 10 shoes and still you're saying, ayap, juta na yun la pole, you're praying for another shoe, that's called wants. To learn to differentiate between needs and wants, okay? Because God knows what you need. And God will provide what you need. Amen? But till then,